नमस्कार एंड वेलकम अगेन टू प्लेनेट टू सोल एस्ट्रोलॉजी. सो फ्रेंड्स, होप यू ऑल आर डूइंग वंडरफुल. एंड येस, टुडे आई हैव कम विद द टॉपिक ऑफ अवर असेंडेंट लॉर्ड. आई हैव मेड सेवरल वीडियोज रिलेटेड टू दिस, बट यू नो अवर असेंडेंट लॉर्ड, दैट इज़ अवर लग्नेश, प्लेज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रोल थ्रू आउट अवर लाइफ. Now you have to see that where your ascendant lord is posited, how is the strength of your ascendant lord. But before starting my video, let me tell you all that do not forget to subscribe and share and like my channel Planet to Soul Astrology, and also do visit my website planettosoul.com. If you are seeking any type of astrological consultations, please go through my website. So our ascendant lord, now whatever ascendant sign is rising, that sign related planet becomes your ascendant lord. Say for example, your rising ascendant is Libra, so Venus is the 7 number sign, so Venus becomes your ascendant lord. And in your whole life, the prominent planet or the focused planet throughout all your events, throughout any Mahadasha, Antardasha, throughout any Sade Sati also, Venus will play very vital and crucial role. Now you have to see that where your this Venus is posited in your chart, right? And this Venus will also hammer and enhance the fruits of that particular house where it is posited. If you are Taurus born, so same Venus, but you know difference between this Taurus and Libra. So today I just wanted to make you all aware that same planets have been provided two zodiac signs, right? But Makar Rashi has different criteria, Aquarius has different characteristic, same way Taurus has different criteria and Libra has different characteristic. So here Taurus is something connected to negotiations, understanding, diplomacy, whereas Libra is connected to being very liberal towards the things, balancing the or equilibrium between two things, two events. Libra people knows that even though my work is done through somebody, but still I have to maintain good relationship with this person. Whereas Taurus will see that how I can take out work from this person by speaking good language or by being very sweet and very attentive towards that person, but only for that period. Sometimes we can call these people as swarthy people, but you know, they are by default. It is not that they are not helpful or something, but that is their inbuilt nature. Same way, if you are Makar Lagna or you are Aquarius Lagna, so Aquarius is something connected to research or detachment, because Aquarius is again Mula Trikona Rashi of Shani. So now what will happen, that this Aquarius sign, wherever is Aquarius Lord Saturn, wherever is going in your chart, so definitely that house related research, that house related orientation, that house related relatives, it will definitely make it very prominent to give fruits, you know. And also Saturn of Aquarius being your ascendant lord will definitely make you more virakta. Whereas if you are Makar Lagna, so Makar Lagna is something sthira rashi, sthira prithvi tattva lagna. Makar Lagna is something where Venus also gets very good fruits. Same in Aquarius also, Venus becomes the functional benefic planet. But whatever in Capricorn you get, because in for Capricorn this Venus, which is functional benefic, goes in 10th house of chart. Okay, that sign goes in 10th house of chart. So you are more karma oriented, you are more profession oriented person. Whereas for Aquarius, this Libra, this functional benefic planet will go in 9th house. That means that sign goes in 9th house of chart. Venus can be anywhere in the chart. So your total focus will be more on spirituality, on research, related to ninth house dharma, or you are just trying to maintain your humanity. Whereas Makar people or Capricorn people, they have solid and strong mind thoughts. They think very sharply, like deer. They think always. I say that I compare their thought process with deer. But when time comes to put that process in reality, then it is something like they are jumbling that how to put it into action. Same way, if you will see, friends, Mithuna and Virgo sign. So both is Mercury sign only, but Mithuna is very superficial. Mithuna is something that these people really want to know everything, and after half knowledge, immediately they want to react. Immediately they want to reply that yes, I know all these things, I can do anything. But this Virgo people, they are very less, they do not reciprocate that things. Or even though Virgo people are very introvert, so wherever your ascendant lord is going in your chart, again I will say that particular house they are focusing on, and that particular house related fruits you will get into your life. Say for example, if you are a Virgo ascendant and this Mercury is going in your fourth house of chart, so even though whatever situation your Sukhasthana, whatever situation your relationship with your parents, with your mother or with your surrounding people you have a focused mind to make out, to take out the situation in a very logical way, and then you will see that how you can react. Whereas if you are a Mithun Lagna, ascendant lord goes in fourth house, immediately you are reactive, immediately you are jumping into conclusion that yes, yes, I will do anything, and maybe it will end up in messing up the things. So this is the difference. But both the signs are very research oriented sign. Mithun is satisfied with 50% or 60% of research, whereas Virgo is not satisfied even with 100% research. This is the difference, friend. So same way with Jupiter also, like Jupiter has Pisces also and Sagittarius also. So Sagittarius is Agni Tattva Rashi and Pisces is Jala Tattva Rashi. So Sagittarius will drive you more towards your karmic capabilities. Wherever your this Jupiter is going, being your Sagittarius ascendant, that house related karma you are more attentive. Whereas Pisces, wherever is going, you are more attentive towards that house. But Pisces is something like, you know, highly emotional person. Wherever this Pisces sign is going in your chart, or Pisces Lord, that is Jupiter, wherever is going in your chart, that house related relation, that house related signification, you are bound to suffer or enjoy. And if at all with this your ascendant lord, if any nodes are posited, like if Rahu Ketu are coming with it, then definitely that house related deficiency you are definitely going to experience. But you have to know the difference between two ascendant lords. You cannot give judgment that okay, Sagittarius also Jupiter and Pisces also Jupiter. But Pisces is more spiritual and dharmic as well as dual personality, whereas Sagittarius is Agni Tattva Rashi. In Sagittarius, your Mars is very activated. If Sagittarius, Jupiter and Mars are coming together, then it will make you more prominent towards your karmic cycle. It will make you more aware about what you want to do in your life. Like you are very logical as well as you are awakened inside. So this is the difference. You have to see what is your ascendant lord and where it is going in a chart. So next time maybe I will start, if your ascendant lord is going in this particular house, then what type of fruits you will experience. So this is all for today, and next time I'll come with another fresh topic. By that time, stay tuned with Planet to Soul Astrology. And yes, as I always say, Sabka Mangal Ho. May all be blessed. Namaste.